Margaret Farrell George was born in Ireland on December 27, 1787. She immigrated to the United States with her family in 1793. Shortly after arriving in America, Margaret's father and siblings died. Margaret moved to Baltimore, Maryland with her mother soon after. When Margaret was 19, she met Lucas George, a professor of the classics at St. Mary's College. The two were married on Christmas Eve, 1807. Within 13 months, Margaret had lost both her husband and their newborn daughter. During Margaret's months of nursing her dying husband while carrying her newborn child, Elizabeth Seton arrived in Baltimore to open a school. The two became acquainted and a lifelong friendship developed. In February 1812, Margaret joined the Sisters of Charity in Emmitsburg, Maryland, where she was a member of the first group to make religious vows. When Margaret left Emmitsburg, she said goodbye to Elizabeth Seton for the last time. The future saint had been in declining health for several years and finally succumbed to tuberculosis on January 4, 1821. It was not until several months after Elizabeth's death that Margaret returned to Emmitsburg to take charge of St. Joseph's Academy for the next 3 years. Her next assignment was to open a free school in nearby Frederick, Maryland, where Margaret stayed for the next 9 years. The school grew to encompass a large free school, an orphanage, and a boarding academy. From Frederick, Margaret was sent to Richmond, Virginia, where she was again asked to open a school. In Richmond, she and her companions experienced anti-Catholic bigotry, which Margaret noted in her journal with this entry: "Never in any period in my life have I felt so completely isolated and a stranger far from friends and home." In December 1837, Margaret returned to Emmitsburg to take up treasurer duties. During the summer of 1841, Margaret was assigned to head the school and the orphan asylum operated by the Sisters of Charity in Boston. Margaret's next assignment in February 1845 took her to Cincinnati, Ohio, the Queen City of the West, and a hub of the movement westward in the United States. Here, Margaret took charge of St. Peter's Orphan Asylum and School, a mission the Sisters of Charity opened in 1829. By the time of Margaret's arrival, there were 6 sisters and more than 200 children being cared for and educated at St. Peter's. By the summer after Margaret's arrival, changes began to occur in the community. Preparations began for the American Sisters of Charity to become members of the French Daughters of Charity. These arrangements, made by the superiors without consulting the sisters, were announced to them in September 1849. Margaret and some of the other sisters in the Cincinnati mission, after much agonizing, soul-searching, and discernment, expressed their reservations about this change to Archbishop John Purcell. They felt strongly that in order to remain true to the vision of Elizabeth Seton, they needed to remain an American community able to respond to the needs of the American church. When 6 sisters decided to leave the community rather than become Daughters of Charity, the Archbishop offered to support the establishment of the Sisters of Charity of Cincinnati, which happened on March 25, 1852. The new community immediately began accepting new members and also received several sisters from the Emmitsburg community. The sisters continued to operate St. Peter's and within the first year took charge of St. Joseph's Boys Orphanage and St. John's, the first Catholic hospital in Cincinnati. When the first elections were held in February 1853, Margaret George was elected mother. Despite her 65 years, her wisdom, experience, enthusiasm, and drive attracted others and the community grew rapidly. Additional schools were opened and property was purchased for the first mother house. Margaret oversaw much growth and change in the 6 years she served as mother. In 1859, Margaret was elected assistant mother and was assigned to St. Joseph's Orphanage as superior president, treasurer, and bookkeeper. Here she oversaw 19 sisters and about 350 orphans. It was here on February 2, 1862, that Margaret celebrated her Golden Jubilee as a Sister of Charity. Sadly, before the year was out, Margaret suffered a stroke and was forced to give up her active life. On November 4, 1862, she returned to the Mount St. Vincent Mother House, where for the next 6 years she was confined to an invalid chair. However, as one sister recalled, quote, "During her years of suffering, her gifts of heart and intellect were not permitted to lie dormant, but were used to the instruction of the young, either orally or by writing." Unquote. Pupils from the academy, seminarians, priests, and of course the sisters visited her often and received her counsel. Margaret George died quietly on November 12, 1868. In a letter describing the event, Mother Regina Mattingly wrote, quote, "We all feel most sensibly her demise, but know our loss is her gain, for she has certainly made a most happy exchange. 57 years ago, she gave her young heart to her God, and faithfully has that noble heart labored in his holy service. Pray that we, her sorrowing children, may, like her, be faithful unto the end." Unquote. Mother Margaret George is just one of hundreds of women featured in our 2012 Women's Calendar. The calendar is currently on sale from our website for only $5 plus $1.50 shipping and handling. Please consider purchasing one this holiday season. In honor of the birth of Mother Margaret George, we'd like to show you a look at the habits worn by the Sisters of Charity over the years. May Mother Margaret George and her contributions never be forgotten.